going to be. Who's tagged up as Maniac? I know it was mentioned before. Is it Cuban? No, it's not Cuban because I already mentioned
Lord.
Cuban. Lord. Okay, so it's Lord. Neo, Taz, and Pazza. We've got on the Navi side, we've got Edward Markeloff, Zeus, Starix, and C9. That concludes your Alienware roster rundown. Pistol round now underway. No fires as of yet, so very slow, sort of lethargic start from both teams here. We do see two stacked on the inside side, which is just sort of standard standard CT pistol setup. So nothing too surprising so far. Cuban going to be exchanging with, I believe that's going to be, is that Starix? No, it's going to be Markeloff, I think. Yep, Markeloff at the top of the entry. You see him, though, with the Glock in hand. He's just looking for that burst headshot here as he's looking for a catwalk peep, but it's not going to happen. ESC, obviously, well aware of what Markeloff's going to be up to, though.
They are moving towards site in the bomb site now, Navi. And they are bringing the bomb, so, yeah, time to get over towards site in the bomb site and see what team's going to have that first round of this so important game.
Well, there goes the HE and smoke combo to get them entry into the site. We can see we've got five winners towards the catwalk. Zeus on his way in. Bomb is going to be in the hands of C9. Can he get it down? It is being planted. I can hear the plant sign going down. So here we go. Potential retake coming in. Markeloff with the kill onto Cuban, though. It's going to be the Glock on Cuban. Not really what he's looking for on the entry. Neo and Paz are going to pick up kills, though. Markeloff going to take down Paz in retaliation. As we can see, we've got Markeloff here. He's pretty much pinned down, but he's going to reload that clip. Gets the headshot, and really now it's all down to Neo, who's between a rock and a hard place, to say the least, as Starix gets the better of him, and that's really the all-important pistol round here to that T side, and you have to say Navi now sitting pretty, aren't they?
Well, four kills there for Markeloff that first round, so you could say that's a bit important, really. It's a T pistol on trade, getting a four-man.
Plus, it means when that third round rolls around, he's going to have more than enough cash to buy out the full AWP kit.
Exactly.
So Markeloff being Markeloff, that's what he's going to do, obviously. Yeah. I mean, he's going to start picking from mid, or he's going to start picking on Ivy, and he's basically going to be the playmaker. They're going to look to him to create the openings from this point forward now. So, perfect start here for Navi, to be quite honest. That really does put Esk at a massive disadvantage, from my estimation, because of the simple fact that Markeloff is not going to be struggling for money for any time soon.
Let's see where the terrorists are planning to go. They are playing it defensively. They know it's they're playing against an eco here. So
well, they're anti-eco, but it's, I don't think they're going to see a rush here, as you can see.
No. They're just going to calm down. And if they don't experience any kind of pressure or get any opening kills, they will just gather up and go towards inside, it seems.
Yeah, good old Swedish eco just run into the AK-47 fire of Starix, as they probably go in, to be honest. But it's really one of these situations now on ESC's team. As you can see, the lower site entry coming in. It's basically a shooting gallery down there at the moment, and Neo is on the receiving end of it. Bomb is going down, so there we go. There's the plant. And as you can see, the retake slowly coming back in. We've got Lord pushing forward now. He's not going to get any real damage done, though. He's going to be shut down by C9 and Edward with the SMG. He's going to leave just Cuban here with just 41 HP now. He is actually... as you can see, sorry, I'm on the X-ray. I'm going to actually get away from auto director and drop onto him. As you can see, he's making his way through CT spawn. Obviously, just trying to grab himself a weapon. Not going to happen, though. It's going to be a 2-0 scoreline. To be XO, isn't it, Walkline?
Yeah, it's totally expected. And seeing as the CTs can't really plant the bomb to gain that extra money, they will be looking at another eco round here. Markeloff, surprisingly enough, picks up that AWP for the third round, which I kind of disagree with. You don't really want to risk it against an eco losing it. It gets put down from an A down to 57 HP as well. It's not a great opening for Markeloff, I would say, Jay.
No, probably not. He's what he's probably going to do now. It's probably not even worth spectating, to be honest, because he is probably just going to sit behind the AKs and just look for those loose kills as they appear on the peaks. Which, to be honest, ESC being not necessarily an aggressive team, although, you know, scouts on eco rounds at WCG would tell you differently, from pretty much the same position that we see Pazza in now. That was probably my favourite moment in all of esports history, but they're not necessarily renowned for that. That was sort of, you know, the exception to the rule rather than the rule itself. And again, Markeloff taking that damage early, that is going to slow Navi down, but it's not going to be a difference maker here, is it?
No, I don't think so. Pasha did a little Harlem shake there on upper. Don't know why. We see Navi pushing out towards that outer bomb site now.
There we go, nade in hand. That's going to be over towards the Z connector. Edward and company well in control of the outside site now. So just a case of cutting off this this rotation here. The rotation's going to turn into a retake as the bomb gets planted. Headshot coming in from Markov, so that AWP being put to good use despite the fact that he's only got 57 HP. He's obviously not too skittish, and a second kill to follow up on Taz. That's going to leave Paz out as last man standing. Let's find out where he is. He's over towards CT steps here. He's going to be trying to be sneaky. He's going to be looking for the headshot here to perhaps grab an AK, but probably not going to happen for him. Nope, he's going to be shut down. That's going to be yet another flawless round here for Na'Vi. So not only are Na'Vi in the sort of driver's seat, it's not like they've lost a lot of cash. I mean, you can see from the scoreboard, only two deaths on that Na'Vi team out of the first three rounds. So they are going to have a surplus of cash here. Even if they lose the next round, they're going to be able to buy twice, aren't they?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. Markloff would be will even be able to buy another op, so they'll be fine losing this round. I'm quite curious to see. Let me check the overview on my PC here. Yeah, so what we're seeing from Na'Vi is pretty much the standard setup for them, even in anti-eco. So they kind of rely on this, which is a pretty normal strategy, to be fair, because you cover all entry points to see if the CTs are doing something funky, something offensive. And then if nothing happens, the call will just call for a site to push onto.
Well, speaking of a call to site, the site to push onto, it does seem like we are going to be going inside here. Obviously, first gun round of this game, and what an important game it is. I mean, really, ESC need this victory so much right now, don't they?
Yeah. It will be disastrous losing this game, as we touched upon earlier. They will go on to finishing third in the group. They won't be out of the tournament, but obviously it does affect the seeding, and they will have to play another group stage.
Not quite sure what Autodirect is playing on here. I'm going to drop this one to one of the Na'Vi members because it does look like it is going to be basically an inside entry again. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. Edward's going to be flashing out onto site. Looks like we've already got the entry going down here, so I'm going to switch away from Autodirect because it's doing a terrible job at the moment. It seems like we are going to see Markloff have to back up the ramp. He's going to open up with the AWP. Does manage to pick off. That's going to be Lord that he did pick off, though. It does seem like Neil's going to reply, though, with the M4, so that's the AWP down. 3-on-2 situation. Bomb still up on Starix, though, so if they can get this bomb down here, they could make it interesting. But saying that, Taz has got something to say about it. He can shut down Edward, and here comes the headshot. Bomb carrier down, round over to ESC. That definitely makes this proceeding a lot more interesting. Now, as I said, you should see a buy here from Na'Vi. Be very surprised if you didn't. There we go. AK's being purchased. Does Markloff have the AWP? No, he does not. In fact, no, he does, sorry.
He does not have all the equipment, though, so...
No, he's missing some of the
accoutrements. It's a sign that, obviously, he's not rich, but he can afford to buy that weapon. Starix actually pushing quite offensive out, and it's a fast push onto the outer bomb site here.
To be honest, this could actually work out in Na'Vi's favour if they do reset the cash and then maintain momentum, obviously. Oh, cheeky little push out of side, though. They've managed to get the headshot onto, that'd be Lord. Paz eventually shut them down, but I think that's a good trade there, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It's completely fine. It's down to a 4v3 now in favor of ESC Gaming. So it looks as though they are looking to turn this game around. Something that is needed when you play CT on train.
Yeah, most definitely. You've got a dogged determination. You've got to hold on to that momentum. You cannot afford to give away anything more than sort of five rounds here to these T's on this map. And then Markloff putting that AWP to good use. He is going to get a pick. So back to a level situation, 3-on-3. Obviously no bomb down, though, so still in favor of the CTs here in my estimation. Really, it's all going to be up onto Markloff here to get these picks. I mean, if Markloff can actually get the pick from Catwalk here and shut down... In fact, it's going to be Edward who's pushing Catwalk. It looks like Markloff's going to go ramp. If they can shut down the defense here, if they've not made this entry, they could get the plant and could hold out. As it stands right now, it's relatively even here. I mean, nobody's really got the advantage coming into sight. Saying that, scratch that, Taz with the M4 kill. That's going to shut down Markloff. Zeus follows from the M4 from Neo. So just Edward left alive here. I'm going to switch over to Edward. Let's find out where he is. Yeah. He's actually retreating. Yep, smart move. He's going to try and save that AK here. And basically, I think they're going to base a fake strat around that AK now. Would you think that would be what would happen?
I think they might do a set strat or a fast push based on it, and using the ecos as bait, pretty much, tanking up the shots from ESC. What they can do also is just try to utilize that AK to get some opening kills, picking off people at upper inside, for instance.
Well, as you can see, Markloff still way out in first place, 9 frags on the ball for him, but because he's purchasing that AWP, obviously, it does mean that he is going to be, he's going to be probably the most skint member in the whole game at the moment.
Yeah.
Now we are going to see, it's going to be Lord and Taz picking up the frags on the entry there from Pop Dog. Bomb is going down, so cheeky little plant here from Markloff. And it looks like they're going to use Starix to try and cover the plant. Now he has managed to actually get out of there and grab himself an M4 as well off the TK, so not really what ESC were looking for here, but it's still 4-on-1 situation. You'd be a fool to think that there was any chance of Na'Vi pulling out of that, but to get a plant out of that situation, to remove $3,000 on the TK as well from the ARPA, huge deal. So as a good run for them, even though they didn't even threaten like they was going to win.
You think that team kill was planned out in their strategy with the
flashes? No, I don't. I wish that it was. I wish that, you know,
that would be sick.
Yeah, I think it was just a happy coincidence for them, but sometimes happy coincidences are the difference, aren't they?
Yeah, they are. It's, small mistakes can matter a lot in the end of the game, to be honest. Pasha gets that opening kill onto Starix. Which is huge. The Na'Vi team have bought this round. And Taz also getting that kill, so pretty much going in the way of ESC right now.
See Lord up in the Eagle's Nest here, opening up from heaven. He's going to spray down with that M4, eventually dropped by Markloff, but Markloff's position was called, and Cuban gets the better of him with the M4 headshot. So the 3-on-1 advantage, just too much to overcome. And now we're seeing a scoreline of 4-3 in favor of ESC. Now, it's to be expected. There is a heavy CT bias. I think if Na'Vi walk away with 6 rounds from this, they'll be ecstatic, won't they?
Yeah, they will. As you said, the game thus far totally makes sense. Na'Vi winning the pistol, winning the 2 ecos. ESC got weapons, won 4 rounds in a row. So obviously ESC can't really afford to lose a lot of these gun rounds.
Now, I do like what Markloff's doing here. He's obviously not got the money to buy, but he decided, well, I'll purchase a Galil. Next time they come round, he will have the cash for full offline. So,
yeah.
Good money management here from Na'Vi. I wouldn't expect anything less from the guys, to be honest. I mean, they are just about as seasoned as you can get a Counter-Strike team. So, this sort of situation where they find themselves down by a round on a heavily CT-sided map, it's not one of those things that's going to they're going to sweat about. I mean, really, at this point now, I'd still say they're in the ascendant position. And as long as they walk away with a minimum of 5 rounds, they're going to be pretty confident about taking this game.
Yeah, still a lot of rounds in this first half, so the game is far from over. It's pretty much at a normal state, I would say. It's not in anyone's hands just yet.
Yeah. Obviously, if that CT momentum does start to get away from Na'Vi, then they're not going to be able to force them onto eco come the late stage of the first half. But even so, I do perceive them picking up, you know, 2 gun rounds here to make it a 10-5 scoreline at the very least. Now Zeus on the entry from what used to be Ivy in 1-6. He is going to open up with that AK. Starix also falling from the Cuban. You see 2 return kills from ESC as Starix comes in with the AK-47 frag. 2-on-1. Paz are the last man alive, sneaking forward with that M4. He knows the plant is going to be down here, but is he going to play it smart? Is he going to try and pick off C9 here first?
Oh, he's in a great position to get that kill, but
not quick enough to capitalize on it.
No, not at all. That was pretty much a little bit of a fail bunny jump into the opening between the trains there, which ultimately led to him making some form of sound for his opponents.
It wouldn't have been that bad if he'd made the sound but made the jump. You know what I mean?
If he hadn't clipped on the jump,
you're going to give yourself away when you fire the AK anyway. But
he kind of gave it away too early, which pretty much cost him the chance of clutching that round. It's 4-4, and both teams still got weapons.
This is really the turning point now. If Na'Vi can pick up a couple of rounds here, they can. I mean, they're almost guaranteed first place in that group, let's be honest. Let's not sugarcoat it. They are by far the most accomplished team here. And really, if you're betting against them, I think you're a bit of a fool at this point. I mean, it might be worth it, you know, if you're actually really betting, just because the odds are going to be so stacked, you know, against them.
Yeah.
Well, I say against them, it's in their favour, obviously, but you wouldn't want to gamble when it's, you know, it's almost even odds.
Yeah, against them in
yeah,
that
so you might sense. You might want to place a bet just for, the, you know, if you're
just
actually...
for the fun,
yeah,
shits and giggles. And
well, not even shits and giggles, because there's a chance, like, you know, dark horse, yeah, you know, somebody finishing first, it's going to give you odds of, like, say, 10-1 if you were to go for the ESC or something like that.
Yeah.
So it might be worth it on that front, but really, if you just, you know, if you're just picking a winner for this tournament, you'd be a fool to pick anyone over the NMP at this point, until proven otherwise, of course. Yeah. I mean, we could see ESC turn on the style here and capture some of that 1-6 form that made them, you know, world famous. But from what I've seen so far, it does seem like Na'Vi are going to be perfectly capable of making this a fairly drawn-out game, to be honest. I do see it being about a 16-12 scoreline, but a fairly comfortable 16-12.
All right. I still got my fingers on ESC gaming. That might sound a little bit weird, but yeah, I'm still thinking ESC will be able to pull one out of the hat and win this one. But we'll see. Navi has done great so far on this T side. If they can just get just one more round, it will be good enough for them, seeing as they have Markloff. Oh, down to 6 HP here. Gets taken out.
As we can see, Taz quite comfortable on side here. He's not going to be stressed anytime soon. 4-on-4 situation, but obviously eco round here for Navi, so you would anticipate this going relatively easy over towards ESC. Maybe one or two more weapons lost, but nothing that's going to be, you know, too stressful, especially considering they've racked up now 5 rounds in a row. In fact, no, sorry, not 5 rounds in a row, actually. They had the 4 rounds, 1 round break, and then obviously back on it now. So I don't perceive them being too troubled here by this 4-man outside push, which we are seeing now. Lord from above, back in the heaven spot. He's going to open up with that M4 and does manage to pick off Zeus. Now, one advantage of that heaven spot is once you find cover, you're almost going to draw everybody else's fire, and that's why we see the rotation come in, and then we see the cleanup afterwards. I mean, it's one of those spots where you only have a set amount of time once you actually drop pop to try and hit that spot.
Yeah.
So you've got to focus as much fire on it as possible. That does allow the Z connect to come in, clean up, which is what we just saw.
Yeah.
Well, War Clan at this point, are you seeing anything that ESC are doing particularly well?
To be honest, I don't see anything that anyone is doing particularly well or bad. They're playing it out the way they should be.
Yeah.
So it's kind of hard to come in with any form of arguments for why they should change their game right now. I think it's still a little bit too early to call it as well. Navi should kind of feel positive about these 4 rounds thus far. As I say that, the action starts, Jay.
I do think Navi have had more success on the inside site, but obviously you can't just keep hitting that inside site over and over because the strats do get adjusted. Speaking of adjusted strats, it looks like Taz has just come back from his Z connector spot, and he's going to pick up the final headshot. That's going to make it a 7-4 scoreline. Fairly standard so far, like Walkerland alluded to. Really, at this point, I mean, your standout player in server has got to be Taz. 14 frags, 5 deaths, so almost a 3-to-1 kill to death ratio at this point. I mean, Markloff has dropped off a little bit. He's not been finding the frags with the same sort of ratio. He's now on 10-8, whereas he was it 9-1 at one point?
Yeah, 9-1, I think. Yeah, with that over. Yeah, just a 6 start for Markloff, really doing quite a lot of difference. We see Navi here and just on an eco, so not a lot to really play for. Nice play here.
Paz are just completely destroying Markloff's face. Not much that really could be said there. In fact, no health removed from ESC at all in that push. Might as well have type killing console, to be honest.
Jumped off the higher, you mean?
Yeah, we could see a 5-man suicide if things continue this way.
No, well, it's always enjoyable to see eco frags anyways, as long as they're nice. So it's good. It's about good entertainment, I would say.
As we can see, a bit of a split push here coming in from Navi. We've got Edward going his own way. It looks like he's going to be fulfilling the role of scout here and just trying to, you know, feel it out, find out exactly what's going on.
Oh, wow.
Push aggressive from side here. But Ivy is going to be just a, well, I mean, what really could Navi do here? They've got the AWP on Ivy. They can't really approach that now. And, well, saying that, Paz is falling back, so I suppose they could. But it's still going to be held on a good angle here for ESC. They're a man down. They need to do something here, and they need to do it quickly, don't they?
Yeah, they kind of got tipped off of balance. Zeus was just pretty much doing the Harlem shake in T-spawn there. He was just looking around, jumping around. Did not expect that push at all. So whatever they had planned for that round did not happen, as Edward has
Edward
done
just
a
gifted
James Bond onto that side.
Yeah, he was just gifted a frag. He looked at that and he was like, oh, free kill. Cheers. Thank you.
And that has opened up the site for the remainder of his teammates, as Markloff does get that bomb planted, Jay.
Yeah. So I still can't get over Neo rolling around that inside site like he was Stevie Wonder. That was impressive. Anyway, regardless, we are seeing the advantage being curbed now. Cuban going to pick up the M4 frag, and it looks like Lord's going to grab the M4 kill to Markloff.
Oh!
Starix coming through with a hat trick. Nicely done. 2 headshots and the frag on Cuban. Made that a 4, man.
Oh, wow. That is phenomenal play by Starix, coming in at the perfect time and also being able to get all of those kills. Obviously, the first one would be easy, but the 3 coming next to it, every single CT knew the position of that player.
Yep. It would have been called. It wouldn't even need to have been called, to be honest. They were all within earshot. They knew exactly where that fire was coming from, but completely powerless to stop it, to be honest.
Wow.
Now, we are seeing another round here where everybody's fully bought up. So this is one of those rounds that is absolutely pivotal. ESC need to close this out, need to win the final 2 rounds. and probably pick up pistols to have a chance of winning this game here. Now, Navi just need to keep doing what they've been doing. They've been, you know, pretty consistent. They've been hitting that low site with a lot of force. Their entry hasn't required a ton of flashbangs, so they've been good to knock the retake back, or at least slow it down to the point where it's a very awkward retake. So really the playstyle from Navi so far has been nothing short of impeccable. ESC, it has to be said that much the same, really. I mean, nobody's made any glaring mistakes here so far, have they?
No, not at all. It's just like the differences has been individual performances, like Markloff getting that four-man in the also important pistol round, yeah. And obviously Starix. Without those two and those rounds, we would be looking at a completely different scoreline.
Yeah, well, I mean, as that's you can see, first and second on yeah. Navi scoreboard, so it really is one of those situations where, to be honest, if it wasn't for Starix and Markloff, ESC could probably be looking at sort of like a... maybe a 12-3 scoreline here?
Yeah, I mean, that
has been the difference that they have made. So whilst we were saying that nobody's really stood out, I mean, you could argue that Markloff and obviously Starix most definitely have. Speaking of the two, they are both still alive. Commentators kiss of death there as Markloff gets shut down by Taz. That's going to leave Starix as last man standing. Now what's he going to do here? Is he just going to look to actually get the entry? He is.
Yeah, it's fine, man. It's only four players left, so he's used to killing four.
Standing fur, really. Yeah, there goes the time. So I guess he was just trying to grab that AWP. Did he get it?
Oh, yeah. Three kills.
Yeah.
Wow.
Well, I'm really happy I managed to click the mouse in time then, because I was thinking, when's Auto Director going to switch me to what is obviously going to be a fight here over this AWP?
Yeah.
So glad that I did. Anyway, as you can see from the scoreline, 9-5 now the scoreline, and really I suppose both teams can walk away happy with 10-5 here, can't they?
Yeah, absolutely. I think they will be more than happy. ESC will be happy, considering they've lost so much Navi in practice, getting the amount of rounds which is normal and what you need as CT. They will be happy. Navi, I know for sure they can work out from five rounds.
Yeah, Navi are not a team that's going to fold under the pressure of, you know, playing the sort of the less favoured side second. I mean, yeah. they are one. The favoured side second, yeah. I should say. They're not a team that is easily influenced by side bias and things like that. They're just going to get the job done. You mean methodical, not slow, methodical.
Yeah.
Patient is another word that you can apply to the playstyle. They're going to take ESC to pieces on that CT side, slowly but surely. And I do still perceive a victory here for Navi. I think the CT side is just almost indomitable. The second you give Markloff, you know, bank balance to work with in an AWP, he's going to cause you real issues. I mean, even if it's only, you know, like stopping the entry, the point, you know what it's like. As soon as that point guy gets shut down, the guy behind him is automatically just terrified on the entry. And yeah. He's, you know, he's flirting all around. He's looking. He's basically, he doesn't want to concentrate on the AWP. He knows the AWP's there. He knows he's got that split second to get in whilst the next bullet's being bolted. But he also knows that's going to have been called, and probably the guy in catwalk is now going to be looking down.
Yeah.
So really, I mean, it's the first time I've seen that in a long while. We see the Molotov coming from that. Seem like we are going to see the retake here come in, and really Edward's not in a position to do anything about it, as you can see.
Oh,
takes a tag. I think that was for a friendly as well. Yeah. So he was fortunate that Lord actually was in the way to take that bullet. It didn't stop the frag from coming in though. So. The scoreline has to be expected, really, wasn't it?
Yeah, and it has to be said as well. Navi, obviously, this map being a map where the AWPs have a great value. Markloff, being that sick gamer he is, he's going to be playing it out from C connector, which pretty much means for ESC that no matter what site we attack, Markloff's going to stand there with an AWP, and. That's just a horrible, horrible feeling.
Yeah, absolutely demoralizing. There's nothing worse than hitting that Polish brick wall and then finding yourself sort of, you know, being picked one by one, because he is a smart enough player where he's not gonna stay there exposed for any period of time. He's gonna peek, fire his shot off, and usually he normally would then rotate through CT spawn if he knows his game's been goosed. So.
Navi just pretty much rinsing ESC.
The pistol round here well underway, and really that CT side bias just showing to the forefront there, and Navi picking up the pistol round now, so two rounds subsequent to this should follow, and really that should bring it to a two-point game. So from that point forward, it's basically, I mean, Navi are going to have to do something spectacular to throw the game away, aren't they?
Yeah, I think so. Navi will pretty much get six of the rounds in this game will be because of the pistol rounds. So ESC really needs to step up. They can't only win, they kind of need to win by a lot as well. Like, if you know what I mean, they need to really outperform here and show Navi who's boss.
Yeah, it has to be convincing because obviously these two teams are more than likely going to meet for the late stage of the tournament. The fact that they've obviously played against it, now the eco bash is out of the way, there's a reason I'm not talking about that because that was a full-blown conclusion. But there's a reason why Navi probably feel a bit superior here because, as was alluded to before in the pre-game, they are practicing against each other. It's pretty much the only team that Navi are playing against. And on a fairly consistent basis, they're getting the best of ESC.
Yeah.
So at this point, I mean, ESC, to be honest, haven't really shown the full potential yet. And I think the same can be said about Navi, but it seems like during this tournament, Navi have come close to sort of achieving their full potential. Whereas ESC, and as you can see, Markloff double kills.
Wow.
Triple kill, beautifully done. He's going to go for the forfeit. It looks like Starix is probably not going to find the frag. No, Lord's going to shut down Zeus. We do have Cuban above. He's going to jump down. Beautiful headshot onto Edward as he drops down. That's the fourth kill for Markloff. On for the five here. Let's drop onto him just in case he does get it.
He will get it. Yes! For Markloff, and it's outstanding.
Against an eco bash nonetheless, but still a very good,
on the mood, mate?
Well, you know, you've got to point it out. You can't say that.
It's valid.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, ESC in a gun round wouldn't have given up those five frags to Markloff. I mean, how many times at this level of play do you see that? But that being said, it was still an outstanding five, man.
It was, indeed.
So taking nothing away from the man, just throwing that out there. Anyway, speaking of Markloff, the man, the myth, the legend, as you can see, is covering that very tight angle. Obviously, the angle from side here onto T-side of mid, not what it once was, so it's not as effective a spot. But to be honest, Markloff using it, he's a good enough player where he can take advantage of that spot. And to be perfectly honest with you, I mean, the way that spot now works, because it is somewhat underutilized, you can actually catch opponents on the work. Pazza on the boost down to the chain link fence. He doesn't know that there's a second man that's going to be C9 stacked just behind there on side. Fortunately, he has decided to actually rotate over the rest of his team, because if he would have pushed that, that would have been for sure giving up an AWP.
Yeah, pushing up there with the AWP with a guy holding close with an M4, it's going to be terrible for him.
Pazza again playing very passive. ESC not wanting to give anything away here. They want that one-man advantage before they even start the posture to move towards the bomb site. Well, it's like I said before, Navi are not going to make any fundamental mistakes here. They're going to give them easy frags. I mean, you saw the entry being shut down, so 5-on-4 now in favor of Navi. And we are seeing the push start to come out now. A little bit of lag there, a bit unfortunate, because that would have been a good kill for Cuban, but as you can hear, the bomb being planted now, it does seem like ESC in a good spot here, but I do perceive the retake coming in, because as you can see, we've still got Markloff left alive. Now, Starix has been shut down. It looks like Zeus is also going to be taken out, so let's see what Markloff is up to. Markloff with the headshot. Can he pull off some more, you know, classy play here? To be honest, I think he's going to save. He'd be a fool not to at this point now.
Yeah, considering he's got that AWP. If he was a rifler, pushing up with an M4 could be a valid option, but it's going to be way too hard with that AWP. Wise decision, sitting back with that AWP.
Well, first gun round going over to ESC, and that was a much needed round, to be honest. That's now going to make the score 11-8. And really, I have to say at this point now, with the scoreline being the way it is, it's still anybody's game.
Yeah, totally. Let's see. Right. So it's the first round that they've gotten this second half, but it's also the first gun round. So I stand by my choice. ESC will win this game.
The one interesting thing is, though, the fact that Markloff managed to get out of that AWP does make this now a light buy. So, in fact, looking at the actual, looking at the grenades that are stacked up, it's not that light, to be honest. So, not far from being a complete buy here for Navi. So, again, one of these pivotal rounds in Counter-Strike where the momentum is going to shift if Navi do lose this round. And really, if they do, I mean, it's almost an... It'd be an uphill struggle for them, to be quite honest.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, all ESC need from that point forward is four rounds, and they are capable of taking four rounds even on the T side, so... Markloff deciding to fall back onto the ramp here. So, again, fairly standard play across the board. Nothing too outstanding from anybody so far in this round. No one's made any mistakes, no one's made any aggressive moves. As you can see, just a lot of posturing for position, a lot of respect being shown here, isn't the walk-on?
Yeah, it is, and what I'm... what I'm seeing is ESC plays kind of the same style as Na'Vi did on T. Pretty much just looking for those offensive CTs, and when a set time comes around and they haven't seen anyone, they will just push somewhere as they are doing now, as Starix picks up that first and second kill.
Starix holding the angle from the third train, and he is going to have Zeus to back him up as well. Zeus takes out Taz. Now it's going to be Neo with the AK-47 frag, and he's going to get a second one onto Markov as well. That's a huge kill. Bomb is going to go down here, and this could very well be the turning point of the game. Saying that, C9 from behind stops the bomb plant. Paz is starting to push forward. He's going to run straight into C9. No scope. Nicely done.
I'm seeing the second one as well. I think he saw him in connected. Did he not?
There we go. Time runs out. Even though the final kill comes in. Yeah. Kind of unfortunate for ESC because I honestly think they deserved the victory on that round.
Yeah. Quite clearly did. That was such a great frag from Partial there as well. Getting that pretty much jogging no scope with the up there and finishing up the last CT probably 0.5 seconds after the clock went out.
You know what I think is an indication here that ESC is starting to sweat bullets? Look at that buy. That buy is so messy right now. Yeah. Considering that they had the momentum and they're just literally, they do not want to give up anything here. What they want to do, well, they want to take as many rounds as possible, and obviously going for the mixed buy here, I don't really advise it when you're only, I mean, this, you're talking, what, 11-9? There's not much in it whatsoever, so why would you go for a Galil-based buy, you know what I mean?
It might pay off for them, Pasha getting that opening kill onto Sanya.
Just call him C9.
So, good start of the round for them. Let's see how. Na'Vi actually got three CTs on that inner bomb site. So now Zeus is rotating onto that outer bomb site. So it's pretty much split here. But Starix is kind of holding that outer bomb site alone. And it looks like ESC are pushing towards that bomb site.
Yep, it seems like it's all going to be up to Starix here. He's going to shut down the Ivy entry. He's got smoke cover as well. So he is in a good position to call Zeus forward to cut this rotation here. It does seem like they are going to see the bomb site slowly being pushed on. ESC knocked back though by Zeus from that Z connector, and as you can see it's now a 4-on-3 situation. Bomb being planted. Cuban does manage to get that down on the slide, but he's dropped in return. Starix, Edward, and Starix again picking up kills for Na'Vi. That's pretty much going to leave Neo here as last man standing. 3-on-1 situation. He is dropped at Pop Dog. That's going to leave a nice simple defuse. No defuse kit from Na'Vi, which is kind of surprising to be honest, but to be honest, money is so tight at this point for both teams.
Yeah.
I suppose it's not that surprising after all. Markov, he is going to have the AWP, so obviously he's not sweating his money this time. Really now it's up to ESC here. They're going to be on the eco. This should go tight game at this point, shouldn't it?
It's going to be really tight. I kind of agree. They're tight on money, and they decided not to go for defuse kits. What that basically means, yeah, is when the bomb gets planted, they just have to react faster. They can adapt to not having a defuse kit, so I think that was a wise decision, going for those flashbangs and smokes instead of the defuse kits.
Yeah, I mean, if the flashbangs mean you get into the site earlier, then that sort of offsets the lack of defusal, really.
Yeah.
Now, we are seeing Taz pushing forward. It looked like he was thinking about the plant, though, but he's managed to get into the smoke, and he has got the bomb, a bomb down, in fact. It wasn't Taz, it switched on the auto-rider, so it probably would have been Lord, actually, who's now pushing out the smoke. It's all going to be shut down, but again, another cheeky plant. And, an extra, call it, is it $4,000? I think it is across all five of them.
It's going to be about $4,000, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, so it's a little less than that, I think, but not far from being $4,000 across the whole team. So, again, that's your grenades bought if you buy run. Yeah. I mean, when you look at it that way. So, it's one of these situations. Now, any kind of authority on this game, we'll take it. Two rounds in a row here, in my estimation, secures this game.
And we see a buy coming out from ESC, but they could not afford an AWP, so they will not be looking to get the opening.
No, it's going to be hyper aggression here straight out of team mid. That's the only way of playing it if you don't have that AWP to counterpick. Taz is again going for another cheaper plant. Does manage to get down. All five of them still alive this time, so compared to four, in fact, made that free from Na'Vi here as Cuban managed to get the headshot onto C9. This is looking more like the ESC that I'm used to seeing from 1-6, to be honest. That high progression on the rush out, the quick plant, and then the smoke cover to go with. All obviously coordinated strategy here. It was obviously called way back before it was even attempted. I've seen it's going to be Lord with the headshot onto Zeus. At least Markloff and Edward left alive, and it does look like they are going to be saving. I think, yeah, Edward was going to try and get a couple of exit frags there, but obviously not going to happen for him. Markloff way back in CT spawn. He's going to save that AWP. And we are going to see basically ESC back in the ascendant position again, anticipating perhaps a light buy here. Yep, it does look like we are seeing a light buy, weapons being tossed around spawn. At this point now, this is kind of do or die for Navi, isn't it? I mean, if Navi give up this round, you'd expect a double eco after it, which should put game point for ESC on the board.
Yeah, I'm a bit, I'm not sure about that buy. Did Mark Luff afford an AWP? Yeah, okay, then it's
well,
fine.
He saved an AWP, didn't he?
He saved that AWP.
I mean,
so
that's obviously forced the buy based around that, but to be honest, what I would have done is just put Mark Luff inside, leave him on his own, stack four outside, and then, you know.
With P250s.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would be a viable option as well.
I mean, either way, I suppose. I mean, but I mean both valid strats.
The second half here, the score is 6-2 in favor of Navi, so they are clearly in the driving seat, even though the 12-11 scoreline kind of makes you think otherwise. So I don't think it was a bad decision at all going for that buy from Navi. They've got the flashbangs, they've got their armor and helmet as well. So all in all, it was a good decision.
High progression coming out on the T-side of mid-peak from the CTs of Starix. Starix did manage to get a little bit of damage off onto Neo, so the trade there, well worth it. He did take some HE splash damage, but dropping Neo down to 16, so Neo's going to be pretty much harsh language of taking down at this point, really. And we are seeing ESC here. It doesn't seem like they've got any sense of direction here. They're not committing to anything. Saying that, as I say that, it looks like we are going to see an Ivy Rush that is going to be shut down. Lord with the entry frag, though. So back in the game here as Lord moves forward with the AK, picks up the kill into Markloff. Markloff caught with his pants around his ankles.
He got stuck.
Yep, it was just an unfortunate situation where he found himself backed into a corner with nowhere to go. M4 fight coming in from Edward. That could very well make this an interesting round as Zeus versus Taz now. And there's the kill from Zeus that keeps Navi in this game. If ESC would have won that, I mean, you can see Zeus there trying to get to Markloff's ADP. He didn't get there in time. But really, I mean, the fact that they've managed to maintain economic control here means that really now we are seeing a position for Navi where they should take this game.
Yeah. From where I'm seeing now, this is Navi's game. And what a way to clutch it by Edward. Probably only got two kills there, but also getting the information about the last player, so Zeus could gain that advantage in that 1v1. So overall, well played here by Navi. And we see another kind of fast push outside here.
Oof. Well, I was going to say Cuban on 2 HP. Might as well count him out of this fight, to be honest. You've got that's going to be Zeus who's shooting down Neo. Lord's still alive here with 100 HP, but he is in a 3-on-1, and he is going to be shot down by Starix, so the defuse coming in. Should be any moment here.
What? Do they not see him? Oh, there we go.
There we go. Okay, I was going to say, I mean...
Chonya gets the kill onto Cuban there, so... and I'm not sure... they got the bomb planted, so obviously they will have money to buy. Question is, will they have enough for the kind of gear they want?
I think they're gonna be smart here. They're gonna eco this, push it into 14-12.
No, it's going to be an eco from them. They have put a lot of money into grenades to secure that bomb plant.
If they can get another bomb plant here, that sets them up for a double buy, even if they lose on game point. So, good money management here from the guys over at ESC. To be honest, most teams would still get greedy and look for the victory here and say, well, screw it, let's buy. We can still win this game. While they could, that's a gamble that, you know, in group stage, it's just not worth taking, is it?
No, I don't think so. I think it's a wise decision from ESC to do this. A bit surprised that they'd gone for that inner bomb site, though. Might turn out okay, but I mean, every time they've went outside with that kind of eco, they've got the bomb planted. So a bit of variation here from the ESC lineup, and here we go, Jay.
Heavy inside push coming in. We're going to have four members going down the ramp. Markloff shutting down Taz on the entry, though. And really now, with that bomb down, I suppose that's objective complete here for ESC. That's all he was really looking for. We're going to see what Autodirector's doing. There we go. We are going to see the final frags come in, and it's going to be a nice, easy cleanup for Navi. But the fact that they got the bomb down means now that they can get the double buy in here to, even if they do lose, you know, to game point, they can still be in the game and with a chance of a draw if they manage to string together three rounds to close out the game. So it's... best of a bad situation, really. They knew that the best they could do there was an aggressive rush and just a quick plan.
Yeah, and even getting the bonus kill onto Edward, which always, like when the money's as tight as it is right now, it's going to be great for them. So really, really important round coming up here, Jay.
Yeah, Markloff, he's going to be looking for that AWP shot onto the exit on team mid. It's not going to happen for him, though, so I'm going to switch back over to auto direct. We've got Molotov out just to slow down the CT push here onto T side of mid. It does seem like ESC quite content to sit back and again look for this initial pick, which, for my money, it's not going to happen. I mean, how many times have we seen Na'Vi actually play rash and really push? The only times they have done is on e-calls when they're trying to get a quick plant.
Oh, Pasha really close to getting this this kill here, but yep. The spamming of his teammates kind of scared him away from that upper area, so not going to get that opening kill, and Tass even being put down to 57 HP, Jay.
Yeah, but Zeus did take some damage himself, so fairly even trade there on the peaks onto the high catwalk on the inside site. And I see Markloff, this is an interesting position for an AWP. He does grab the headshot. Now he's going to have to move quick sticks here because he could be shut down if ESC do commit to a push, but it doesn't seem like they have. They're quite content to let Markloff get away with doing that amount of damage. At that point, would you have forced the entry if you were calling?
It's hard to say, really. I've never been a caller, so it's not my cup of tea, really. I just full commands Zeus and Neo getting that two kills. Totally changing the outcome of this round. 3v2 now in favor of ESC.
That could be such a huge difference maker. I mean, just those two frags there and then the bomb plant to follow it up. Now, it's this round should very well go over to ESC. As you can see, all five members of both teams who are in server right now, well, as I say that, Edward shoots Neo in the face, but everybody else had 100 HP at the time. Now, Cuban dropped to 16. It's 2-on-1. Edward, your last man standing from Na'Vi. I think he's just going to try and save that AWP for Markloff here. That's definitely the smart thing to do. He's going to exit back towards CT spawn. Does manage to get out of there with the AWP. So at this point now, with the scoreline being 14-13, Na'Vi are probably going to be a little bit cash screwed here. I think they're going to buy, but they're not going to have... Yeah, as you can see, Zeus isn't going to be purchasing any... He's got one flash, so not exactly the stuff that's needed to slow up a rush here. But as you can see, Lord's not exactly stacked with cash either, so... saying that, he just bought his grenades late, so it's just going to be Cuban who's struggling for grenades here.
Offensive Pasha going out into yard and gets that opening kill onto Edward.
Yep.
Important frag from Pasha, flexing his huge biceps there and doing the wise thing here, Jay, just pulling back after getting that kill.
Yeah, I mean, once you establish the advantage on that T side, 5v4, there's nothing to stop you from sitting back till about 30 seconds and just hoping that you're going to pick up another loose frag. As I've said, you're not going to see that from Na'Vi, but it's, you know, still worthwhile just, you know, extending it as long as possible. Looking to do a little bit of damage on your peaks to make the entry a little bit easier. To be quite honest, though, the longer the ESC leave this, the easier it's going to be for Na'Vi to actually hold on the bomb site, because all they have to do at this point now, they've still got flashbangs in reserve, is as soon as it hits sort of 35 seconds, start throwing those flashbangs out, force it into the point where they have to entry at a disadvantage, which is not going to happen now because Lord's just picked up the headshot onto Zeus, so there's not going to be the amount of flashbangs in play on that lower site that are going to be needed. And in fact, it looks like we're going to switch to a pop dog dive and a T-side mid-push, so interesting play here from ESC. We're going to see the connection flank coming in, that's going to be Markloff shut down. No, we could very well see tie game here. So from what looked like it was almost a certain lock here for Na'Vi onto game point, has now turned around to what could very well be an ESC victory. So that buy that I was alluding to, the one that could have gone drastically wrong, has turned out to be a huge boon for them. And now they find themselves with the possibility of taking away 3 points from this game.
That's going to be absolutely huge for them. And it's still a bit early to call. And if we kind of look at it from a different perspective, it's the second half is 9-4. Obviously in favor of Na'Vi, but on the, ESC is on the roll, Jay. I stand by ESC winning this game still, even though it's as close as it can be.
I think you're going to come out looking like a genius at the end of this game, to be honest, because like, not many people would have picked ESC. I think everybody knew it was going to be a close game, to be honest. I predicted 16-14 in favor of Na'Vi, so... I don't think either was a too far from the mark. It's one of those games where, again, as we've seen all day, just little individual performances here and there in you know, particular rounds that are the difference maker. I mean, Markloff's pistol round where he picked up four frags was, you know, a huge deal, but not nearly as much as Taz and Neo's performances have been so far. And I guess to a less degree, Lord as well, who's been, you know, the entry guy. Now, we are going to see the bomb explode here. Markloff going to decide to try and retreat with that AWP. So they've conceded the draw here, and he's not even going to get away with the AWP. So
that's a huge loss for them coming into the last round.
Yep. You can see Markloff instantly buying the FAMAS. He knows that he's not going to have the money for it. So this should be, I mean, a victory here for ESC. Are we seeing a pause here?
I am a bit sad if the actual stream, not the stream, but the GoTV went down.
Yeah, I was going to say, I didn't see any pause message. So that seems like that could very well be GoTV going down.
No, well, when they pause in GoTV, you don't see the pause coming down.
Well, yeah, but if it's a pause on GoTV, yeah. But why would they pause the GoTV?
No, because obviously, the pause is in about, let's say, 4 minutes or 3 minutes ahead.
Ah, okay, so we don't see, actually, yeah, no, you're right.
But you still have a valid point. This round, anyway, who wins, there's no reason to pause the game because the game is over.
Yeah.
So I'm a bit concerned about this hiccup here when it's 15.
Yeah, I was going to say, technically, the round game is live, so, I mean, how many leagues do you know of that wouldn't play a live round like that, even if somebody does drop? Can you think of any leagues that would do that? I mean, CPL never did it. I know ESWC never done it. WCG have always had the round that once the rule that once the round is live, it's live. So I really hope that's not a proxy problem where we've lost TV, because that would be tragic.
It shouldn't be, considering